As people were busy sowing the 2014 wheat crop, Ground Cover TV looked at GRDC's early sown wheat project, which followed on from the Eureka Prize-winning National Water Use Efficiency Initiative. Now, the objective is to get as much crop as possible to flower at the optimal time for maximum whole farm yield. So when optimal flowering time arrived, it was time for a follow-up. October in southwest Victoria. Southern region wheat crops have been through an unusual growing season, but this should be the best time for flowering, whatever the variety.
Most wheat in southwest Victoria gets planted from the middle of May onward, and lots of it gets planted in June. And I guess part of our project is we're trying to get people to realise that a lot of the varieties they're planting then aren't suited to those sowing dates, so they should either be pulling them back into early May or late April, or switching varieties that are faster to mature. And that's what this trial's designed to demonstrate.
So this Southern Farming Systems trial site at Westmere is the testing ground for sowing strategies using varieties commonly grown in this region. All of the trialled varieties were sown three times, on the 24th of April, 15th of May and the 5th of June. It's a high rainfall zone, but only 250 mils was recorded during the growing season.
So this is Bollocks sown on the 24th of April and we're on the 16th of October and it's just past mid-anthesis, so most heads have now flowered, the grain's starting to fill. So this is really where we want a crop to be sitting in this part of the world at this time of year. This is forest sown on the 24th of April as well, and as you can see it's heading now but it hasn't started flowering yet, so it's going to be a bit late in this environment, and given that it's a dry season but also in an average season, it's going to flower too late, run into drought stress and heat stress, and its yield's just not going to be as good as something that flowered at the optimal time.
But if you sow the slow spring variety Bollocks a few weeks later, in mid-May, it's a very different outcome.
This is Bollocks sown this time on the 15th of May, and we saw down the other end of the trial that when it was sown on the 24th of April, it was mid-anthesis and flowering right on time, but here it's flowering too late. It's going to be penalised for yield and probably quality as well.
In comparison, mid-spring variety Trojan, sown on the 15th of May, does much better than Bollocks.
And you can see that most heads here have just flowered. There's still a few that are still to flower, so it's really hit that optimal flowering window. And I guess it's really what we're looking for in terms of maturity length for a middle of May sowing.
In 2014, severe frost events in July and August caused more than the usual damage to cereal crops. The freezing temperatures hit stems as well as floral parts.
What we learnt was that slow maturing spring wheats are much more vulnerable to stem frost than winter wheats. So say a variety like Forest versus a winter wheat like Wedgetail, if you sow them both on the middle of April, both of them will flower at the same optimal time, but Forest starts to elongate, starts to run up much earlier than a winter wheat like Wedgetail, and that's when you become vulnerable to stem frost.
It was the type of season to challenge most research trials.
It's the first year where I think we'll get a demonstrated yield penalty from sowing early. I mean, until the headers go in, we won't really know, but I suspect that's what's going to happen. So I guess that's another year of data to sit with our other years of data that have shown a really positive effect of sowing early and, yeah, keep it in perspective that way.
This trial is about spreading risk and optimising total farm yield. And while no one would advocate only sowing slow spring varieties, this fieldwork is providing grain growers in southwestern Victoria an opportunity to see the consequences of a good sowing strategy.
Our highest yields always come from late April and early May in this part of the world, and from varieties like Bollocks and Beaufort. So they're sort of slower maturing varieties sown in their optimal window really maximises the yield potentials that are on offer here.
For grain growers in other regions, the varieties might differ, but the message remains the same. Select a range of varieties and keep the sowing window within a week of the ideal date to hit the optimal flowering window in your environment.